Hey guys, today we are playing the Don Diego map. Let me bring up the whole map. Right, actually, here, this will be easier. Easier to see on Farm Sim 17, which, as you know, I've been playing quite a bit more lately than other games. So I thought I would check out this new map, new to me anyway, and also record it and share it with you guys because I have not been doing many recordings lately. So, pretty square fields, a little bit boring when they're square like this, but it certainly makes it easier to use automation like helpers on the fields. So I've not played this map before. There's quite a bit of water in here, which is interesting. So that takes up a lot of land, or a lot of space that would be fields. But there's basically no wooded areas here. There's, I think, a little bit, but mostly just for looks. So all you have is agriculture here, which is fine. But you also have a lot of other industries. Now, they're all in German, so my translations are probably going to be off. But there's a refinery here. There's a sawmill here. There's a soy milk production facility here. There's a brewery, a compost manufacturing. And I don't know what backer is. I don't know what that is. Hops plantation, mulch, I guess creation area, whatever creates works, and then a sawmill down here. So, quite a bit of variety of things. And it starts the game off with some very crappy old basic equipment. Case IH 1455, duty truck, which we'll sell right away. Another case, and then the New Holland 40 or 8340. So, and 1660 axial flow, which is tiny, tiny, tiny. They also give you a Eurobus 3300 for picking up grass or whatnot. And then one of these smallest wagons that's in the game. Now, I've bought a couple things, and I bought them by taking out a loan, which is the New Holland BB1290. With the Nadal R90 attached, which is gonna be our way to make money right away. They give you one of these, tiller, fertilizer. Now, I just bought this auto loader. This is the one that I like because it's compact and holds quite a bit of bales. I think it does 4 layers of square bales, which is really good. Then I bought this Novacat. They give you this seeder. I bought this wrapper. And I bought this Novacat. So that's about it for the stuff here. Let me save the game right away. Yeah. And go back here. So here's the game plan. In all these games, you start off with $25,000. Now I've already spent that and I borrowed another $180,000. So I'm way in the red here. So what I'm going to do, and what has worked very well for me in most of these games starting with very little money, is to go mow grass and turn it into silage. Now, doing that is a great way to make money quickly. Let me shrink the map down a little bit so I can see where I'm going. Even though silage prices have gone down, I've realized that it's not really fun playing this game on hard mode because, oh, look at that gold nugget. Because you really never, It's almost impossible without cheating to actually get to a point where you're ahead of the curve. And I don't like to give myself fake money in the game. I like to actually earn money. But I want to be smart in earning that money. Who this is. I thought this was just a silo. Oh, it's a fermenter. Oh, okay, cool. So this will make silage. All right, so that's a cleaner way of making silage than the other method, which is the more traditional sort of filling the rows with chaff and then pulling over the plastic sheets over them. So here's our 3 tractors that came with this map, and the equipment on them is all brand new that I just bought. By the way, the tractors are pretty old. If we look at their ages here, 78 days, 72 days, 57 days. So almost everything in the game is old. Let me sell the truck. Probably not worth a whole lot because that's also old. Yeah, $10,000. I'll sell that. I never drive those trucks when we get them in the game. So let's make a row and we'll use follow me. So this New Holland will be the lead. So let's get him up front. And then, oh, hello. And then Case will follow him. 20 is fine. Don't need to worry about that too much. And then this guy will follow the Case, and that's with a 2.5 meter offset, which should center the wrapper. Now, ideally, I would also have another vehicle following to pick up the bales with an autoloader. And I don't have a vehicle, so... Excuse me. I'm kind of tired here. So without cheating, there's really no good way for me to... All we're going to do is just start mowing the grass here. So let me unfold everything. That was already unfolded. Lower. Lower. Turn everything on. Spinning. That's spinning. Okay. I have to do the same thing I should have done here first. So turn that on. Okay, there we go. Now that's lowered. And then the last thing that just needs to be unfolded, that actually. So turn these back on, and here we go. Let's hope that traffic doesn't kill us crossing this. Oh, this is going to be painfully slow. Oh boy. I really wonder if I should not have all three of these. Let's see how fast he gets going once. So you can see the basic idea that I'm doing here. I'm mowing three rows, so about 10 meters or so. And then I'm running the Nadol to collect it all. And so that new single row is being fed into the 1290. And then that will start making bales. Oh, we're up to six, seven. We're up to seven. Okay, well, maybe we'll keep it. In fact, what I really want to do is this. Go. And just keep going. Perfect. So, width. This will just keep us aligned. Since this map is very square, that's all we really need. Alright, now let's take a look. While this is running... let's see when our first bale comes out. Might be a little while. I just want to make sure that the wrapper catches it. Yeah, we should be doing this at about 12 miles an hour. Or about 18, 19 kilometers an hour. Maybe 20 kilometers an hour. But either way, it is not very fast. Where are you? We're at 90. Okay, so it made its first bale. But it's going to need one more bale in order to push that out before the wrapper can catch it. I'm going to move this guy up a little bit. Make him follow a little bit closer. If he can. Oh boy, that's the other question, right? So I'm mowing, well, right now at 5. I was mowing at 7 miles an hour. Super slow. But... they may not be able to move faster with what they're running either. Well, at least the baler can't, may not be. Okay, so first bale drop. Let's see what happens to it. Through that. All right, good. Picked it up. Sweet. Okay, as slow as this is, figure out our path. So we're going to go to the edge of the map. And then we're at the T there. We're going to take a right. Follow the path out to field 16, take another right, follow that to the road, and then go back across the water. There's a lot less grass. Ooh, I just noticed that there might be a good grass field. Although the problem with doing fields is you can't just turn on automation like this. Well, maybe. Well, there's a field under field 38. The other thing we could do is we could actually seed grass in one of the fields we own. Now, right now, looking at the map, we own 28 and 29, which are tiny, tiny, tiny fields. so it may not be worthwhile. What I was thinking of doing is taking, if we had more fields, I would just maybe seed grass in one of the fields and just do grass. But I think for the time being, this is probably going to be the only thing we can do. All right, two bales, yay. Now we're going to need, I'll tell you what the rates are based on memory, so I might be a little bit off. But based on memory, I'm going to need, let's see. So 4 times 8, so 32. So 32 bales is about $100,000. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 bales now. So a long way to go. I need 28 more bales to make the first $100,000 in this map. And of course, remember, I borrowed $200,000 already. So this is, I think the next chunk of money, the next $200,000. You know, I could actually take a right here. I could either take a right or go straight and then follow the edge there. I don't know if it makes a whole lot of difference. I guess I can take a right up here. That'll be good enough. Well, no, I'll get more grass if I go straight. All right, I'll keep going straight. So I think the next $100,000 is gonna buy us a new tractor. There's a modded tractor that is in Ursus brand, I believe, that I've bought before in other maps, which is fairly cheap because it's made in what used to be Eastern Europe. But it is pretty good in terms of horsepower rating. It's not horribly huge, but it's a under $100,000 tractor. Oh, look at that. We're going to put that right on the road so somebody hits it. Perfect. It's an under $100,000 tractor, which nonetheless gets up to, I think, 180 horsepower. And to get to 180 horsepower using American or European tractors, like Western European tractors, German tractors, you're going to end up paying closer to $200,000, maybe $170,000. So I think we're going to go with the East European one. And it's actually kind of a pretty tractor in white. You can get it in white. It's a red and white tractor. Okay, now we're going to turn. I'm going to turn as far away from the, there we go. Stay as far away from the field as I can. Get ourselves set here. There we go. And just keep following this path. Now, because I'm not using course play, I'm just using, GPS mod. I can't get out of the vehicle. If I get out of the vehicle, the tractor stops. It's sort of life realistic. I mean, in the real world, technically, I have seen farmers on videos actually get out of their vehicles, get out of the tractor while it's running in GPS, go grab a cup of coffee, come back, jump back in. But you're also not supposed to do that. Obviously, the GPS is not a full automation conversion for the tractor. It is a partial automation just so you can relax rather than having to keep driving in and keep a very precise straight path while you're doing it. So actually there is, I think, is it a New Holland or a Case? One of those two, I think it was a New Holland, that had a fully automated tractor. So essentially it's, if you can imagine, a tractor with no cab and some antennas sticking out of it. Looks like something that's a cross between a full-size real-life tractor and a remote-controlled toy. It is full-size, but if you zoom out, it kind of looks like a remote-controlled toy. But that tractor is meant to be autonomous, or, well, semi-autonomous. So it's following a programmed course. It's going to observe for any kind of abnormalities along that curve. If you have a deer runs in front of it or something, it'll stop, make noise, presumably, and scare the deer. But But it's really, it doesn't have a cab. It doesn't have a place for anybody to sit. So we can take a look at the cabin here. Let me get rid of that. That's the pricing. It'll be a while before we sell anything. You can see on this map, there's an awful lot of things to sell. Poppies, cotton, corn flour, wheat flour. See what else? Board pallets, cheese, beer, milk. I don't know what Beckhorn is. Homogenized milk, bread, yogurt, millet, tricale, which is, I think, a flour. Felt, which I think is another flour. Difference. Okay, that's all the same. Slurry. Oats. Oats is new, right? And hops. So all of those can be bought and purchased. But I was going to get rid of that. In fact, I can do this. Get rid of everything. Have a nice, clean, unobstructed view from inside the cab. There's our farm back there. I think that's one of the purchase locations as well. How are these guys doing? Are they following? Yep, they're following good. Whoa, where am I going? What the heck? That was not right. I don't know how I ended up wandering off the trail. Range. Okay. Well, they're going to follow me whatever I do. So that's the good thing about using follow me. So this map is not horribly beautiful. It's not like the Kleinhau map that I had on the last video, which is absolutely gorgeous. You can see the trees are planted in pretty much straight rows. A lot less detailed creativity went into this. The edge of the map is flat, or well, it's a mountain, but it's a mountain that happens to have an absolutely square edge. The fields themselves are square. There is a little hill, not a mountain, but a small hill over there. You can see the trees over by the farm are planted pretty much in a row. So a much simpler looking map. But the advantage of a map like this is it's a lot easier to actually, I'm gonna move over just a tad more, like so. Maybe, oh, there we go. More. There we go. The advantage, and the reason I moved over, I want to maximize my grass yield. I think I was mowing beyond the edge here. So, but a flat map like this is obviously a lot easier to use. The, as I mentioned, I hit everything. Fill the map again. So the fields are all square, so they're a lot easier to use automation for plowing. It's just in general, you know, a simpler way to get around. You can either follow square roads that are all at 90 degree angles, or just cut through fields because there's no fences between them. So it makes it for a little bit faster gameplay. But what I wanted to do is try actually starting this map and not sell any equipment except for the pickup truck, which I hate. But just use the equipment we have and start, obviously, buy some new equipment. Generally, what I'll do is I'll sell all the tractors, I'll buy just one or two tractors, and I'll buy this with the proceeds from the tractors, start mowing, make cut enough grass, bale it, and then make enough silage where I can make a couple $100,000. Then I'll buy a second tractor, which will be a much better tractor, a replacement, and just sort of use that equipment to keep growing. And then if you noticed on the last video on the Kleinhau map, I was actually using the Big X, or it's not the Big X, it's the Big M. Who makes that? I can't think of them off the top of my head. Starts with a K, I know that. I'm just having the brain fart here. Can't remember. I'll think of it in just a second. But anyway, using that. So I was actually made enough money off of baling grass, making silage, and then selling the silage to where I could actually afford to spend $300,000 to buy the Big M. Krone. The Krone Big M. which makes the whole process go much faster. And then setting up a course play course to have the Kroneg do all of the cutting fairly quickly on a grass field, which that map has huge grass fields that are just nobody's. You can just start cutting them. All right, let's get out of the cab view for a second and take a look. Make sure we're still wrapping correctly. It looks like we've wrapped. I don't see any bales missing, so I think we're doing a pretty good job of picking up the bales, which is no surprise, because at 5 miles an hour, everything should be dropping perfectly. I mean, the once we upgrade the tractors here, the normal speed. By the way, this is not a small map, okay? So let me zoom back up. This does look like it's a, based on how far we've driven, this is probably as big a map as Kleinhau. It's just not laid out like a natural features map. It's not a satellite image map. Or if it is, I would be very surprised. I suspect it's a made up map. Because we've gone not very far. We really only moved field 6 and, well, field 14 up and then field 6 over. So really, we've moved the size of field 14 and a little bit more than that. And yet it's been probably, 15, 20 minutes in doing that. So large map, square map, not gorgeous to look at, a little bit boring, but should be fairly fairly good for automation. And I don't really want to get out of here. I was curious to see how much some of these larger fields are, see what kind of pricing the map creator set up on here. But I guess I won't worry about it for now. Oh, nope. Oh, I thought we missed one. Nope, we picked it up. There's another bale getting wrapped. So we're going to go to the end of field 16. So over by the trees, take a right. And then we'll just keep doing this for a little while. I might actually speed this section up, guys. Maybe I won't talk for a little while, and we'll just speed this up so it's not quite as boring to watch. But also, you can see what I'm talking about in the last video where I said I think playing this game is a lot more boring for the viewer. It's kind of fun if you're doing it. Now, granted, just sitting here doing nothing, because everything's running in a straight line with automation here, may not be the funnest things. But once I make some money in this map, and I can actually buy some new equipment, start actually buying some of these larger fields, there's an awful lot to do, because, as I said, there's a whole bunch of different commodities here. A lot of things that are not on normal maps that we can make, like beer. I've never been on a map where you can make beer. That's very cool. Make milk. Make soy milk on here, cheese, so a lot of cool stuff. And I've got some other mods that are not on here right now, but that allow for greenhouses that can make strawberries, raspberries, and red currant, which is a really good berry. But they're fun because they're a lot more complicated. It's not just a matter of providing fertilizer and water. You have to do that, but you also have to provide cardboard boxes and wooden pallets. So you need two other manufacturing facilities to be able to make the cardboard boxes and the pallets. And to make that, you need wood, obviously, to make pallets. And then you need wood chips as well as pallets to make the cardboard, because the cardboard boxes come on pallets as well. So, more extensive process. Now, you probably saw some of that when I was giving the tour of the Kleinhau. So, anyway, so I said I wouldn't talk, then I kept talking. I'm going to shut up, and we'll just fast forward through this next section. Okay, guys, we're coming up on the turn, so I'm going to, I decided to just come back the exact same way. The reason for that is it's going to make it a lot easier to pick up these bales, because I won't have to follow two different paths. I'll just be able to do one path. Now, downside of doing this is that we're going to have less grass here, as you can see. So I'm giving up a little bit of grass in order to be able to do this. But I think the convenience in picking up the bales is going to be worth it. I'm going to guess we've probably got probably somewhere around 40 bales right now already anyway. So more than one truckload worth of bales. Oh, just missed one. Is it worth going back and making it? Or should we have a grass? Let's just have a grass bale. You can always use an extra grass bale for something. Or I can always wrap it later too after we pick it up and collect it. That's the other option. What I could have done is just taking all of these bales, instead of wrapping them here out in the field, could have just brought them all back and then wrapped them one at a time. Now that's, unfortunately, if I do it that way, that's a manual process. This is a little more automated, because I'm just driving in a straight line, so these bales just come out of the baler and then go right up into the wrapper. There's a perfect example of that. So the bale came out perfect. Came in right between the two lifters of the bale wrapper there, and it's able to pick it up right away. All right, how far are we going? We're going a little ways yet. Actually, we're going quite far. We've got this field, and then we've got field 6 to go back. So I'm going to revise that number. I don't think we... Okay, I need to move over a little bit to the left here, it looks like. We probably don't have 40. We probably have more like 60 bales by the time we're going to be done. No? Let me just back, just add. Like so. All right, so now we should be able to get maximum amount of bailage from the grass here. A lot of time what I'll do is I'll use the new Kune self-wrapping baler. I can't remember the model number on it. But it's the round bales, and the same machine is a baler, and then it also has a wrapper in it. Part of the new DLC for the game, which is pretty damn cool. I like it. I know people are complaining about paying that much money for DLC that just adds a few things. You know, every DLC for previous versions of this game have only added a few things. The DLC that had the IT runner, a lot of people complained about. You know, now a standard free DLC for this game. So basically, they've taken all the old past paid DLC, and then they've given them away, which works quite nicely. So for this current DLC, I think it's the same thing. I think a lot of people are complaining, but ultimately, it's going to be seen as a pretty good DLC. Yeah, I'm running into that error where if you're too close to the edge of the field, you're not going to get grass from it. So I think I might just back away just a slight bit back to the right. That, just to be a little bit further away from the edge of this field that somebody else owns. This is a big field, by the way. If I get to the point where I'm buying a field this size, it looks like 14 is probably the biggest one on the map, right? Yeah. Probably, or maybe 71 on the bottom there, although I think 14 is bigger. But yeah, that's got to be a multi-million dollar field. Even Field 7 that we just drove past is not that small field. And here, that's a very small field.